between his rants, his preaching, and his outbursts, sometimes it's just too much. He just wanna throw something through his window. Hey, Stephen A., what's that over there?
Bruh.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching The Fumble. I'm your host, Jackie Ray. While you're here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Turns out that thing over there was a turkey vulture that was flying around and decided to try to smash through Stephen A.'s office window in Bristol, Connecticut. You can see that big dent, that one right there? Yeah. That was caused by a turkey vulture. They couldn't find the vulture, but I personally hope he's okay. My guess is he decided he wanted Stephen A. to get a first taste of his beak as he was telling Max Kellerman that Conor McGregor's retirement is because he doesn't have the heart of a champion.
All I'm saying to you is that because of that absence of the eye of the tiger, we in the media, because he is box office, keep talking about him like he's a champion. He is not champion.
Stop. Come on, Steve. Stephen A. The man has 21 wins and 4 losses. 18 of those wins were by knockout, and 4 of those wins happened in the first round. You can't really count the loss to Floyd Money because, well, it's Floyd Money on his turf. Plus, we all know this retirement is only going to last as long as there is no money on the table. This man loves to fight in the ring and out of it. Trust me, he'll be back. But I get what you're saying, Stephen A., so maybe that wasn't it. But I know you gave that bird a reason to try to get you to pipe down.
I'm talking about it's the UFC, it's with Dana White. If Conor McGregor really, really wanted to fight, you trying to tell me there would be only 2 events in 3 years?
Well, yep, see, there it is. Somebody find that bird and make sure he's okay so he can try again. Calm down over there, Stephen A. Nobody thought LeBron was going to come to this city and win with this team, not even a championship. Come on, stop it. You can't try to reinvent the wheel and put LeBron in a system without a consistent and effective shooter with a bunch of kids who are all still growing and think the outcome is going to be different than what we see now. But I will give it to you. Last time LeBron missed the playoffs, we didn't have iPhones. We didn't have Instagram or Twitter. So maybe this is just foreshadowing what life will be like without my King James. Not something I am looking forward to, but luckily we have Zion Williams to look forward to, right? Don't blow this for me, Stephen A.
I've talked to NBA players who are grown men that have said, I ain't taking no offensive foul from that guy. Already, he ain't even in the pros yet, and they see him coming.
Okay, you can call off the vulture. Crisis is averted. Duke will take on Virginia on Friday as we enter the Sweet 16 in March Madness. Duke barely pulled out a win against UCF, but the real question is, did UCF just show Virginia or anyone who may come after how to beat Duke and Zion? My first thought is no. No matter what you do to hold Zion, he is massive and can bully his way to a win. And if you focus all of your energy on containing him, you still have RJ Barrett and Cam Reddish to deal with.
They're gonna struggle from the free throw line. You know they're gonna struggle from 3-point range. You make them a perimeter shooting team.
Yeah.
Period.
Okay, well, we'll see if Virginia follows your blueprint, Stephen A., but we know you want Zion in New York, but what's odd to me is he doesn't think the NBA actually needs Zion. In a recent interview with Complex, Stephen A. was asked, how bad does the NBA need Zion Williamson in New York? He said, quote, they don't need him. The NBA is prospering without him. They're certainly prospering without the New York Knicks being relevant. As a native New Yorker and a diehard Knicks fan, I would love to see him here, and I'd love to see the Knicks become relevant again, because it's absolutely excruciating to watch them stink year after year after year. Is that right, Chris? We just had to shout out our editor real quick. Well, if anyone finds that turkey vulture, make sure he's okay and tell him to stay off the weed. But in the meantime, Fumble fan, how many of you are still alive in your brackets? I'm not. Are you heading into the Sweet 16 with confidence? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know who you think is going to take it all. Thanks for watching The Fumble. We'll see you next time.